Hello everyone and welcome to Tareekh. In today's episode, we'll be telling you about Dargah of Matka Pir. पर जब भी मटका पीर की जगह का जिक्र होता है तो बिरयानी की याद आती है, पर वहाँ सिर्फ बिरयानी ही नहीं है, पर वहाँ दरगाह भी है। जो ये दरगाह है मटका पीर की, वो बिलोंग करती है शेख अबू बकर तुसी हैदरी। सो ही बिलोंग टू द हैदरी कलंदरी सेक्ट एंड कलंदरी वर आल्सो पार्ट ऑफ द सूफिस्टिक ऑर्डर। जैसे चिश्ती है, सुरावर्दी है, वैसे ही कलंदरी है। बट बिफोर वी टेल यू अबाउट मटका पीर बाबा, लेट अस टेल यू अबाउट द कलंदरी सेक्ट।
ख्वाजा अब्दुल्ला अंसारी, जो कि 11th सेंचुरी के एक सूफी सेंट हैं, उन्होंने एक चीटीज लिखी है कलंदर नामा, विच इज अ कलेक्शन ऑफ द कॉन्वर्जेशंस दैट ही इज हैड विद ए कलंदर। अकॉर्डिंग टू द कलंदर नामा, कलंदरी हैज टू हैव दीज फाइव प्रिंसिपल क्वालिटीज, विच आर ह्यूमिलिटी, लोलीनेस, सेल्फलेसनेस, एसेटिसिज्म एंड रिनंसिएशन। दे वर सो सीज्ड बाय द इंटॉक्सिकेशन ऑफ द ट्रैंक्विलिटी ऑफ हार्ट that they got rid of normal social pleasantries and the mores of personal relationships. They performed obligatory prayers, but they did not partake in unnecessary prayers and fasts. The Kalandariyas sought to violate orthodox features in their behavior.
So the Kalandars had various groups. Unme se ek the Haydari. Jo ye Haydari sect hai, it's actually founded after a Turkish Sufi saint called Haydar. So he belonged to Sava, that was the province south of Nishapur, and a lot of miracles are attributed to him. कहा जाता है कि during the peak summers he used to walk through fire, during peak winters he would be standing outside in cold weather. According to Hazrat Nizamuddin Aulia, जब भी Sufi Saint Haydar है, when he used to seize with ecstasy, he would actually twist and turn hot iron rods as if they were wax into and fashion it them into bangles and necklaces and that he would wear. Ibn Battuta bhi kehte hain, jo he was a traveler in during the Sultanate period, he also met many Kalandaris and saw them wearing these jewelry. In 1220 the Mongols attacked the province of Sava and lot of these Sufi saints, Haydari Sufi saints, they migrated to India.
According to Jamali, who was a 16th century Surawardi saint, the Haydaris picked up the practice of celibacy and a few other customs from the Hindu Naga sannyasis. They also picked up the practice of piercing the ear from the Nath yogis.
Aur inhi Haydaris mein se jo sabse prominent the, wo the Abu Bakr Tusi, jo Matka Pir ke naam se jane jaate hain. He came to India in the 13th century and he established his khanqah on the banks of Yamuna. When he established his khanqah, a lot of gatherings and sama used to take place. Hazrat Nizamuddin Aulia used to also participate in those sama. And ek aur sheikh the, Sheikh Jamaluddin, jo Hansi ke the, he also, whenever he used to come to Delhi, he used to also visit Matka Pir Baba and he used to participate in sama. Sheikh Jamaluddin of Hansi, he also gave Abu Bakr Tusi a title of Bazaar Safed because of his mystical achievements.
ताजुब की बात है कि शेख अबू बकर की अपने कंटेम्प्रेरीज के साथ ज़्यादा बनती नहीं थी। देर इज एन अर्ली अकाउंट रिलेटिंग टू नूरुद्दीन मलिक यार परा दैट टॉक्स ऑफ सच अ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट। द मलिक हैड माइग्रेटेड फ्रॉम लार इन फर्ज टू डेली ड्यूरिंग द रेन ऑफ बलबन एंड ही वॉन्टेड टू सेट अप अ खानका नियर दैट ऑफ शेख अबू बकर। बट शेख अबू बकर सॉ दिस एज एनक्रोचमेंट ओवर हिज लैंड। So he said to him ki first you get a farman from the sultan and only then you can build your khanqah. We aren't sure where the sultan was at that time. He was either in Thatta or most likely he was in Bengal, but the malik was so fast in getting the farman from the sultan that Sheikh Abu Bakr was very impressed and he gave him the title of para, which means flyer.
Ek aur legend hai Sheikh Abu Bakr ki उन्होंने एक अर्दन पॉट मटके से पानी पिलाया था एक इंसान को who had a disease that was incurable. So when Balban got to know about this, he had sent in the earthen clay pot mud and an arun to the sheikh. So the devotees of the saint, they used it to roast gram and jaggery. जब भी आप वहाँ जाएंगे, जाते हैं, मन्नत मांगते हैं, धागा टाई करते हैं, तो और जब भी आपकी मन्नत पूरी होती है, then you are supposed to offer a clay, earthen clay pot, a matka, and वो एक पेड़ पे लगाया जाता है. This khanka was spread over 20 biga, 8 katta of land, but only the area of the shrine remains. कहा ये भी जाता है कि इस दरगाह में पहले एक जन्नती दरवाज़ा होता था, पर अभी नहीं है. Matkas hang from the trees all around the shrine. When you enter the shrine, you see 16 delicate pillars form engrailed arches and support a flat roof. Mirror work decorates it from inside. The courtyard that surrounds it is always full of visitors, devotees and kawals. Sheikh Abu Bakr died in 1257, but his followers or the ones who were his khalifa, they did not reach that level where he was. And the Haidari sect of Kalandris, they were more famous in the provincial dynasties, especially Jaunpur and the Bengal Sultanate. But there are instances that tells us that they were present in Muhammad bin Tughlaq's court. Sikandar Lodi ke time pe bhi wo the, and a lot of instances have been happened with Sikandar Lodi and Kalandris. And even there's a mention of Babur meeting them. But we're not very sure about that. Ibn Battuta also tells an incident where he met Haidaris in Amroha in 1342. Ibn Battuta had spent a night with the group of Haidaris, and jo chief the us group ke, he asked Ibn Battuta to help him and get a supply of wood so that they can place it on the ground, light it on fire and dance over it and roll over it. And he also asked Ibn Battuta for a shirt. So he gave him this very fine material shirt. So the chief wore the shirt and he rolled over the pyre and beat the fire until it did not get extinguished. So, and then he returned the shirt back, and Ibn Battuta was so astonished to see that there was not even a single trace of burning. So this was the level of the Haidari sect of the Kalandars. When you go to Matka Pir, when you enter that area, you find people selling flowers and tabaruk, and then comes the flight of stairs, and then you approach the main dargah. It's very quiet, it's very, very peaceful, and you feel at peace. You can pray there, you can sit there, or manat mang sakte hain. It's all up to you. I really hope that you've enjoyed today's episode. Please, if you can, do go and visit Matka Pir and sit there for some time, meditate there. It's a nice place to be in. And please like, share and subscribe, and keep watching Tareekh.